Hi, I'm Rama Chellappa. I'm the professor and chair of Electrical and Computer Engineering Department at University of Maryland. The holy grail here is to understand what's in an image, what's in a video, who is in it, what they're doing, when the image was taken, where the image was taken. So we consider all of this as inference problem. Given a single image or a video sequence, how much information can you gather from there? Over the last 5 years or so, we have actively looked at recognizing humans and their activities from unconstrained video sequences. As you know, there are cameras everywhere collecting videos of all kinds. We have looked at what is known as a remote face recognition problem. This problem deals with recognizing faces at 50 meters, 100 meters, and beyond. So we try to capture the motion of the body, the motion of hands and legs and hips and neck and so on in a composite way, and we try to get a GAIT signature. Although we first started off using GAIT for recognition, later on we also used it for identifying whether somebody is carrying a backpack or somebody is carrying a briefcase and things like that, because some of these things can alter the GAIT. Active authentication is a problem of trying to continuously authenticate the user of a desktop or a smartphone. Oftentimes, when we have a smartphone, we log in with our password. But afterwards, if somebody steals our cell phones, we don't know whether we are using it or somebody else is using it. We are looking at fusing face images that are collected by the cell phone camera, as well as the touch signature, which is some form of a gait of fingers, so to speak, and we try to fuse them to continuously authenticate the user of the smartphone.